Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. Today is the Chinese Battle Royale. So as you can see, this it's all of not modern day China, the last dynasty of China, including Korea. It's this. But yeah, Battle Royale, who's gonna win? So almost immediately, what is going on? This is disgusting. Ugh. I don't, looks. Oh, no. Why? Korea looks like it's having a nice vantage point. Yeah. So I left this run from 1936 to 1940. And it looks like almost immediately Korea. Oh, yeah, Sun Quan is a puppet of Qing China. Which one's gonna be the first one gone? I think it's gonna be the Far Eastern Republic. It looks like it's about to fall. I mean, unless Mongolia does something about Tanotuva. And the first nation down is the Far Eastern Republic. Taken out by Manchukuo. Oh, there goes Tanatuva. Yeah, I think the countries in the northern part, all here, are gonna have a better time than here. Because they. Like communist China has to fight multiple fronts. Has to fight multiple fronts. Oh yeah, as you can see on Bhutan. Looks like so m much fighting happening in the eastern Russia. Oh, China is not having a good time. They lost the entire southern front. Oh, Manchukuo is mounting an offensive against Korea. What is your favor to win this battle? My favor is either Korea or Manchukuo. This one or this one. I think they both have equal chances. But yeah, if you do like this type of content and want to see more, then make sure to like and subscribe and comment down below which one would you like next. Because you know. Looks like it's pretty even over everything. Nobody's winning, but nobody's losing. Looks like it's going to complete stalemate. Looks like Tibet is kind of losing to Sinkang. Yeah, it's a complete stalemate. Oh wait, never mind. Down south, the Guangxi clique. They've lost a lot of territory to Yunnan. Oh yeah, by the way, if China ends up with just Taiwan, the other nation we will just ignore them. Ooh, Yunnan is losing territory to Tibet. But yeah, pretty even in the at least in the east. The west is a completely different story. See how many troops Korea has. Because I feel like they could easily beat Manchukuo. 38 compared to 49. Oh, never mind. Right now, it's just a waiting game to see which one will fall first. But yeah, the first two to fall. Tianatuba and Far Eastern Republic. Far Eastern Republic isn't a big nation, and it's not even a starting nation. And then Tianatuba is the lowest populated country in the world at the start of the game. Looks like Manchu is pressed into northern North Korea. If Manchukuo could take out Korea, that means they could turn their entire force on this eastern front, which would be bad because they have either one of the biggest armies, or yeah, they have the biggest army. So if they turn those 57 divisions over here, then it's comp then it I think it's over. They have to. Unless these nations down here can unite quickly, can defeat each other quickly, and then get all this population into an army and go up north, I think Manchukuo's got it. Yeah, they're pushing Korea back out. I mean, all Korea has to do is fight Manchukuo. -1 Celsius. That's cold. Eh, not really. Yeah, I don't think Korea will last very long. Nope. Tibet is actually doing pretty well. They've taken out, like, they own the entire Gobi Desert, at least. Uh-oh, Seoul's open. Oh no. Yikes. they're taking out, and they're taking Chinese provinces. They've taken Pyongyang. If Seoul falls, it's over for Korea. It would be pretty funny if the ones who owned all this territory before won it back. Oh, actually, historical fact. This guy right here is actually the leader. He was the kid that last led him before. Yeah, but I think Qing China's gonna take over Korea. Oh, Seoul's about to fall. Seoul has fallen. Korea is about to. Yeah. Dang. Okay, I think I know who's gonna win this game. Here come the. Here come all the divisions back over. Dang, I thought this one would be interesting. No, they just steamrolled them. Like, dang. Oh, Manchukuo's down. Oh no. Yikes. Yeah, I think this battle royale is already over. I don't think anyone could stop Manchukuo. It's kind of poetic in the way. You know, they lost. They used to have all this territory. Now they're gonna reclaim it. I mean, besides Sing King, they already own Sing King. But even if they would still get steamrolled, so. It's a win in my books. Oh, there goes Shaanxi. Ah, this. It's kind of beautiful. You could just see just the wipe of paint going across. Up, there goes main China. There goes China one. Oh, Yeah, there's nobody stopping them. Dang. I actually thought this would be interesting. It was. It really was. It's just, I didn't expect. I thought for sure China would win. This one. I thought this one would win because it looked like it, because they had. Because I'm just gonna be honest with this. No. I'll just be honest with it. It really did. Because, I'll be honest, Communist China, I accidentally deleted all their cores by accident. So, like, I really thought China was gonna win, because they had cores on everything. Oh, maybe they didn't. No, see? Oh, wow. Yeah, see? They do have cores on stuff. I didn't expect. No, wait. Huh? CC click. What happened to them? Oh, I think it's just a name change or something. Yeah. At least Mongolia can resist them. Oh wow, they actually are. Just imagine Mongolia takes out Manchukuo. Mongolian Empire will rise again. Up there goes China. Hi, China. You back for round two? You're gonna die again to them. I swear, if Yunnan or ZB Senma turns into China, it's gonna be so stupid. Please don't. Okay. I thought the same guy was in charge. Sorry. You really came back to life just to die again. Oh, jeez. Oh, wow. The PRC is actually looking kind of good. Honestly, just listen. This soundtrack is nice. You know? It's a nice, soothing one. I know I got off topic, but it's nice. I don't think you guys could hear it, but I can hear it, and it's nice. Really, really amazing. Oh yeah, leave a comment down below who got that, what is it called, that bonus song for getting Arms Against Tyranny early, pre-ordering it. I know I did. I don't know the name of it, but I sure know I got it. It's like Polka something? I don't know. That tells you how bad I am. I don't even know the song name, and yet I wanted to pre-order it. Oh, I'm just sad. Oh, there goes China too. Dang. At least they lasted longer. I think the run we. Oh, never mind. I think their real problem is they're going too fast that they don't have enough, ammunition and stuff. But yeah. they just... Wow. Oh. Great. We did... Yay, Tibet took another state! Aw, oh, I'm so proud of them. They're doing so well. But they're gonna die anyway, so... I mean, hey. I'm not gonna not allow them to have a puppet. Wow, they really sacrificed the entire territory just to get a puppet, you know? It was a sacrifice, but it was a worthy one. Honestly, the little things in this game kind of make it good for me. Because, like, you could see, like, the slow population increase. Like, you don't realize it, but, like, sometimes, like, you could see this one goes by 61.23. Like, how sometimes Palestine, like, it starts below 1 million at the beginning and grows to it. And, like, it's just so astonishing how, like, the small things in this game just make it, like, that much better. Because you could see the increase of the population. 1.70 billion while it was 1.50 billion at the beginning of the game. Those little things make this game for me. Looks like they've slowed down. Oh yeah, they can't break through a river down here. I mean, they could always go down here, but let's be honest, the AI is not smart enough to do that. Oh, I think Communist China is about to die, which means that the People's Republic of Ma is gonna die too. They've lost the most populous Chinese state and state in the game. Just imagine Showdown versus Tibet versus Manchukuo. Who's gonna win? that would be so funny and dumb. But yeah, if you wanna suggest like nations fight, like the EU versus the Soviet Union or other stuff like British Raj versus China with all of their territory and all of normal China's territory. If you want to suggest that, leave them in the comments below. Oh yeah, if you want to see more videos like this, I already have a video of the Nordic countries, the German countries, Italian countries, North American, and Balkan battle royales that you could all check out after this video. They'll be linked in the description, or two of them will be featured on the end card or the info card right now in the top right hand corner of your screen. And all of a sudden, Qing China takes out the Manchukuo takes out the PRC and whatever they had in the middle. They were actually doing pretty well on this side, but sadly, with that, they have modern tanks? No way there was a modern. Oh, if that, I think this game's over. Yeah, sorry for the, you guys can see immediately what happened. I was, how they did it. I saw, like, them doing that, and I was drinking something and had to mute my mic. I don't know what's going on. Yeah, this entire game I've been playing is Bhutan. I don't know what it's trying to say over there. I just want to watch Manchukuo win. Dang. I feel bad for all the people that didn't say Manchukuo. Sometimes I wonder why the AI is like this. They could easily, like, mod something in here and do something about it. Same thing with this, they can mod an army through here and take there. But no, they choose not to. I don't know why they don't. Same thing with here, they could. That now they're finally doing something about it. But like before, they could have just move, take Nanning, and boom, there goes China. But no, they want to be difficult. Like, wow. Same thing. I don't get this AI. No, don't lose Nanning. No, don't. I'm talking about this city. Oh no, poor Mongolia. The entire Chinese army is heading up there. No way! Oh, there goes China down south. They're holding off the entire Manchukuo army and just pushing back. Oh yeah, Yunnan is dead. They were barely surviving against Tibet and Guangxi clique. But yeah, there's no way they're winning now. How come it doesn't say China? Oh, there goes the Hahas. I don't know how to pronounce that. The city. Oh, Tibet is gone. Oh, there goes Tibet. It's just Yunnan and Mongolia left. So just Mongolia. Oh, I've never seen this in game. I've never seen it. The Chinese Empire. Oh, they got their flag back. Mongolia still. Oh, there goes third China. Jeez, people. You've lost three different times. Just give up. Oh, and for the people wondering, the Chinese Empire would totally be Bhutan. This is just their court. Everything else is just compliance. They would easily destroy Bhutan. Mongolia, no! Oh my god. No way, Mongolia is just winning. No. Oh my god. Is this the Chinese Empire's, Vietnam? There's no way. Oh, they finally got actual units on the field. Oh, I think this game's over. What is Mongolia doing? What are they doing? They pulled off all their lines just to go back to Ulaanbaatar. And then they just abandoned their capital. What is with this AI? Okay, well, they reinforced it. This battle royale has been going on for 5 years. Dang. Let's see. How many people have died? 200. 250. Not including all the others. It's just Manchukuo versus Mongolia. Wait, Mongolia barely has 1 million. How do they lose 100,000? That's their third most populous state. Yeah, that's the third most populous state. Don't think the Chinese Empire can do it. I'll wait here until they actually do. But I'll cut to it when it's done. But yeah. So I've waited 2 years. 2 years, and literally nothing has changed. And they all have tanks on the border, and I'm not gonna get intervened with it, so I'm just gonna say that, Manchukuo won it. They'll eventually do it, but I'm not, my file drive can't take up to an hour worth of stuff. So yeah. And it's already been an hour recording, so. Well, I guess thanks for watching. If you do, click on one of the videos that are appearing now, or subscribe to my channel, as I would much appreciate it. Thank you, and goodbye.